Damn. He's sure got some speedy legs for an old fart.
I'm glad to see you're okay, Zavid.
It's not me that I'm worried about.
Melchior was highly interested in your weapon. And yet he didn't steal it. Surely a legate like him could snatch it if he wanted to.
Why bother stealing it? When you can just copy its hidden formula. Some arts can decipher the workings of other arts in a split second. And guess what Melchior's specialty is?
As he left, he said, "My work here is done."
The Abbey must have some use for that unknown art. Who knows what? After all, they brought it here from another continent.
Then we'll find out what they're after and crush it to dust.
Let me ask you just one question. Why do you have Siegfried?
I'm counting on you, he said. Back when I served the Exorcists, they sent me on a mission to capture Eifried.
Zavid, you were once their slave?
Yeah. My mind was under the influence of Enominat's domain. But when Eifried aimed this baby at me, one shot was all it took to open my eyes. The fight we had after that was one for the books. He might have been a human, but that guy was a beast. Put a song in my soul. But then Melchior had to jump in and spirit Eifried away with one of his damned illusions. That old bastard, playing tricks with people's minds.
But why'd he grab Eifried and not Siegfried when he had the chance?
He probably didn't know at the time that this guy was the real prize he was after. But Eifried knew. Right before he was taken, he distracted Melchior long enough to hand Siegfried over to me. Well, that's all I know. Whether you believe me or not is up to you.
Got it. We're done here.
Huh? That was easy.
Eifried only says I'm counting on you to people he trusts.
Is that so?
So, what are you gonna do now?
Gonna keep looking for Eifried. Still gotta give this back and settle our score.
I doubt you have much time left to get that done.
I'd hazard a guess that until now, Melchior was unaware what Siegfried could really do. In other words, he and the Exorcists weren't able to interrogate anything out of their captive.
And now that Eifried's no longer needed, I see no reason for them to keep him alive.
You think I don't know that?
If you really want to save Eifried, you probably ought to team up with us.
Nope. No can do.
Why not?
You lot will do anything to achieve your goals. Even kill. Sorry, I'm a fighter, not a killer. I won't steal a single life. That's just my creed.
And I've got no intention of changing our pirate creed either.
Aizen and Zavid have their own creeds. They both have such strong principles, even though they're so different.
Just like humans.
Well, that was sure something. Melchior and his illusions are cheats.
There's no cheating in combat.
What I meant is that they were awfully dirty tricks for an upstanding exorcist.
And the illusions seemed so real. Had that gone on any longer, I wouldn't have been able to tell what was real and what was fake.
If it can't be distinguished from reality, perhaps one could live a happier life within the illusion.
That sort of happiness can rot.
You think so?
But by using illusions, you can defeat an opponent without causing them any physical harm.
Oh, how humane. Wow, the Abbey is so great.
Lord Melchior is an exemplary man who has served Lord Artorias since before the Abbey's founding. He's done everything from logistical planning to defense strategy and even political negotiations. He shows the utmost concern, even for his opponents, so...
He turned a friendly Moloch into a dragon.
That was...
Physical wounds can heal. Emotional wounds never fully fade.
Yeah, but...
Don't lose heart, Eleanor. Foul play is foul play, but you're talking to a demon and a witch. Who can judge?
I appreciate that you're trying to console me, but as an exorcist, I cannot accept this.
I thought I smelled someone pondering. What's on your mind, Lafayette?
I know Siegfried comes from another continent and all, but do you know anything else about it, Ropero?
Nope, can't say I do. All I care about are swords. That contraption doesn't interest me much.
I suppose that makes sense. But it looked real powerful.
Just guessing based on how we saw Zavid use it, I'd say it amplifies his power somehow.
An amplifier. It's true that he seemed to get stronger when he fired it at himself.
Yeah, and it gave that dying legendary wyvern enough strength to escape.
But wasn't it also what he used to dispel Melchior's illusions back there?
That was also amplification. The Malachim are the source of his arts. The relic pushed them past their limits and... kablooey!
Suffice it to say, it can be used both offensively and defensively. It must be very hard to master.
More important is what the Abbey plans to do with it. Not that I really care.
Lafayette? May I ask you something?
What is it?
The girl with the umbrella from Lord Melchior's illusion. What is her connection to Aizen? I don't think he'd answer if I asked him myself.
I don't know. I was wondering about her as well. She was pretty, wasn't she?
Oh, so you like a girl who's cute, but with a bit of sophistication.
Really? I thought his type was more like
What's going on?
We were discussing a delicate topic. Lafayette's first crush, if you must know.
Oh.
No, we weren't. We were just talking about the Umbrella Girl from the illusion.
The Umbrella Girl? That illusion made Aizen hesitate. She must be really important to him.
Indeed. It must be a deep, naughty relationship.
Come on, now.
Like, a wife he wants to leave, but he can never let go. Or a lover from whom he can't move on.
No, that's too wild, and she's too young.
Yeah, it's not that. What's more likely for a self-serving pirate is a daughter from a woman who only knows him by a fake name, perhaps one whom he cast aside, or who cast him aside!
And maybe she was somebody he couldn't marry for some reason. But when she died, he raised her daughter for her.
He had been friends with her since they were children, but they only realized their true feelings after they had been married to someone else!
Is this their idea of romance? In any case, beware of girls, Lafayette.
Right.
Whoa! Hot water is
is spouting out of the mountain!
And look at those rainbows.
This is one of the seven wonders of the world, the Bernac Geyser. The water heats up from underground until the pressure forces it to spray up from the surface.
And the rainbows are caused by light reflecting from the salt suspended in the mineral water. It took tens of thousands of years for the minerals to accumulate here and form this phenomenon.
Wow-wee!
That was very educational.
At least you know plenty of trivia, if nothing else.
Additionally, the groundwater veins that feed this geyser are connected to the sea. Because of this, every now and then a boiled octopus or crab will shoot out from the geyser!
No way!
That's impossible. Well, not impossible, but...
with the salt content of the geyser's water, I bet they're seasoned to perfection.
Mogulu, I'm declaring your bizarre imagination the eighth wonder of the world.
People say that all the time.
Scout ship set.
Now what are we gonna do? What's wrong?
This dog came up with a book in its mouth. Here, take a look.
Huh. It looks pretty old. I've never seen this kind of writing before.
It's not ancient Averroist, that's for sure. Part of it looks like a chronology, so maybe it's a history book?
If I were to guess, I'd say they're Meliodasian characters, which would peg it at about 2,000 years old. It's more recent than Averroist, but the writing has fallen completely out of use.
All kinds of notes are written throughout the book, too. Someone must have been studying it.
If it's research material, that might make it Videl's book.
Videl? Who's that?
He's a weird kid who's way into studying history.
He lives at the inn.
Could you maybe deliver the book to him for us? We were told not to get too close to him, so...
Yeah, sure. I guess.
My book! Where could I have left it?
Are you Videl? Is this yours?
My book! Oh, that book is super important to me. Thank you.
I'm Lafayette. I hope you don't mind that we flipped through some of it. Can you actually read Meliodasian script?
You recognize Meliodasian writing? That's unusual in this day and age.
Oh, it's not that big of a deal, really.
When I grow up, I want to be an adventurer who travels the world and explores lots of ruins. So to make sure I'm ready for anything, I've been studying ancient history, starting with the Era of Darkness.
The Era of Darkness? You're referring to the Dark Period, right?
Right. Almost no written records from the age have survived. But if you compare the history before and after, you can tell something major must have happened.
Wow, that's fascinating.
I know!
Look at those two, all worked up over an old book. My little brother was just like that too. Luffy and our brother used to.
We've received reports of suspicious persons in the area. Have you seen anything?
Not good. They're onto us.
Quickly, hide in my house.
Videl, have you seen anyone suspicious recently?
Sorry, sir. I've been absorbed in my book.
That's all right. Thanks. Look, I know it must be tough living alone with your mom. Just remember, your father's a praetor. He's out there fighting to protect us all. Keep your chin up for his sake at least, all right?
Uh-huh. Thanks for your help, Videl.
Videl, your father is an exorcist?
Yeah, he is. But don't worry, I won't say anything about you and your friends. I'm your friend too.
Really?
And to prove it, I'll let everyone in on a big secret. This book tells you how to make an Omega Elixir, an incredibly ancient and powerful medicine. If I'm reading it right, you need 5 ingredients in order to create the elixir. I've only translated one of them so far, but I'll tell you what it is.
That's really nice of you, Videl. But I don't have any way to repay you for this.
Oh, please, think nothing of it. I'd just like it if you came and talked with me again sometime.
Of course. What are friends for?
The Omega Elixir. That's an ancient medicine said to be able to cure any disease. But it was my understanding that no samples or recipes survived the Era of Darkness.
Meliodasian script was used prior to the Era of Darkness, so I guess it's possible that Videl's recipe might be legit.
He's just a kid. I don't know how much we can trust his translation.
You saw his notes. I doubt many adults could even get anything out of that book. He might be onto something.
Kids are more capable than we give them credit for, especially where their interests lie.
I think we can trust Videl.
Luffy used to read books intently like that, too. Furthermore, couldn't a hypothetical Omega Elixir be quite useful to you, Velvet? Luffyzette, you look like you really want to track down those ingredients.
Yeah, I do.
Personally, I don't really care. But if you want to look for them, I won't stop you.
Okay.
This big storm came and swept me out to a Class 4 island, and let me tell you, it's as bad as the rumors make it sound. I wanted to just wait it out in a shipyard somewhere, but then, the water turned all gooey. Then I had these jellyfish things coming onto the deck, and before I knew it, slugs were swimming around in the damn ocean.
Wouldn't the salt in seawater mess up a slug?
Yeah, that's what I thought too, but these weren't no sea slugs neither. It was scary. I'll tell you that much. You want my advice? Stay the hell away from that island altogether. But if you do go, watch out for that gooey stuff.
What did that pirate mean by Class 4? I've never heard of that.
It's a classification the Abbey uses to help inform their strategy, an estimation of how well they've been able to manage the demon outbreak in an area. Administrative zone classes 1 through 3 have been assigned a suitable contingent of exorcists to guarantee the population's safety.
So, Class 4 administrative zones are ones that are still unsafe?
In a perfect world, the entire kingdom would be protected, but there's just not enough manpower to go around. The Abbey doesn't send exorcists to remote areas in far-off islands. Instead, they avoid casualties by making those areas off-limits.
But that pirate mentioned he'd come close to an island. Are those policies actually enforced?
They send out an official notice to stay away, and that's all. It's not like they could blockade every tiny remote island out there. So you're free to dive into the deep end if you want, but no one will come to your rescue. Hope you know how to swim.
If they could keep the demons in check, they wouldn't have to tell people to stay clear. Frankly, I think the Abbey just doesn't want to go near places like that.
In other words, these are dangerous places that the Abbey has washed their hands of.
Makes you wonder how much they can administrate these places when they're not willing to get their hands dirty.
Are there many Class 4 administrative zones?
I've heard of 10 such regions in my time working as an inspector for the Abbey, but I'm afraid I couldn't tell you their exact locations or their current status.
If the Abbey abandoned this island, it's probably safe to assume that it's getting to be pretty dangerous.
If we go there, we're gonna want to be prepared.
Demons! There's more of them! A whole band of them rampaging through Warg Forest!
There was already one dangerous demon in those woods, and now we have more! And they're still on the loose! A lot of exorcists have come to deal with them, but...
What do these demons look like?
That's what I want to know. Those Abbey people won't tell us nothing. Every time a demon comes around, it's all, show us your cargo this, and don't leave port for a while that. How are we supposed to catch any fish?
These demons really are a pain in the neck. If I was an exorcist, I'd lay down some justice, I tell ya. At the end of the day, it's not the demons or the exorcists that have it rough. It's us normal folk.
Anyway, you guys should be careful. There are demons about.
Thanks for the warning.
Sorry to worry you.
And the captain?
It turned out to be a fake. But now I know the real one's still alive somewhere.
Well, of course he is.
Not that he has a lot of time left.
What do you mean?
Calm down. I'll explain later.
Aizen! You stay calm too, okay?
And you've all taken your salatoma?
Yes, sir.
And nobody died?
All still kicking.
Compared to your curse, sir, the sickness was tiny potatoes.
All right. Then let's get ready to sail out.
Already done, sir.
We're ready whenever.
The Pirate's Creed, huh?
There's worse out there.
Is that a fighting arena of some sort? I don't see any demons around.
Look! There's something spewing out of the middle!
I sense a really malicious force emanating from it.
It's probably the vengeful spirits of those who fought and died here looking for glory!
Thanks for that. Now I've got goosebumps.
Let's try not to wind up as more vengeful spirits.
Thank you.
Not worth my time.
Like we won't be joining the party.
I can see why this place is the stuff of cautionary bedtime stories.
Not to mention why the Abbey's keeping way the hell away.
We shouldn't let our guard down. But this place could still be a good chance to hone our combat skills.
Indeed. Most everything we've fought here seems to follow a pattern. This is a good place for tactical training.
If we ever end up on another island like this one, we should probably come prepared for the kinds of enemies we'll face.